नमस्ते बिटिया, हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। डिजिटल सेशन की सीरीज में आज हम एक नया सेशन देने जा रहे हैं, दैट इज बोनिगासन थेरापेटिक पॉकेट बुक पार्ट सेकेंड। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दिस सेशन आई वुड लाइक टू से दैट वी आर ऑल प्राउड टू बी a part of the best women university in India, that is JVW Jaipur. And these digital classes are occurring on digital version 2.0 of JVW platform, which is having the best homeopathic college in Jaipur. Hope I will be able to satisfy your quest for knowledge. Please listen to the lecture carefully and drop your queries in the comment box of the YouTube, which I will answer in the problem solving session. So in this part two, we are going to discuss about the grading of symptoms in therapeutic pocket book. See, in therapeutic pocket book, there are five grade of symptoms. The first one is given. Sorry, we are not talking about grading of symptoms, but here we are talking about see, the book is having rubrics. The rubrics, they are derived from symptom. The symptom we get from drug provings. In drug provings, how many patient develop those symptoms, in what intensity, and then when applied clinically, how many patients are cured by application of that medicine based on that symptom. This makes us to assess what is the grading of medicine. So the first grade is the capitals, or the five grade medicine, is based on the symptom that is proved in almost all the provers and has been repeatedly confirmed in the clinical work. Then second grade, here the medicine is given in bold and it indicates that the symptom is produced by most of the provers and has been repeatedly confirmed in clinical practice also. Not all, but many provers have proved that symptom. The third grade, italics, indicates that the symptom is produced in provings less often but still clinically confirmed. The fourth grade, which carries 2 marks, indicates that the symptom is produced in the proving seldomly but has occasionally clinically confirmed. Then the fifth grade, which is given in bracket or in parenthesis, which carries 1 mark, indicates that the symptom has occurred rarely in the proving but still sometimes clinically evaluated. Now the plan of Bonigasan therapeutic pocket book was to construct a repertory in 7 distinct sections. The sections are mind and intellect, locations, sensation and complaints, sleep and dreams, fever, condition of aggravation and aberration, that is modalities, relationship of chapter remedies, that is concordances. So about the mind and intellect, Bonigasan was well aware of the potential of mental symptoms. Therefore, he kept the mental symptom on the highest in his 7 points of totality, that is quiz, Q-U-I-S. But as he was not able to dissect it, to include them in the repertory, therefore he took only a few symptoms which are so commonly observed in clinical practice. So the mind chapter and the mind and intellect chapter is the shortest one in the repertory. Thereafter, the location chapter is very rich, contains location starting from the head to the lower extremities as per Hahnemannian schema. Then the chapter sensation and complaints. It contains sensation and complaints for the generals, for glands, for bones, and for skin, which includes subjective and objective, both type of symptoms. The other chapter, next chapter, is the sleep and dreams, which includes rubric like yawning, complaints without sleepiness, with stretching, yawning, ineffectual, spasmodic yawning, falling asleep late, impossible after waking once. Here it means sleep impossible after waking once, sleep prevented by various symptoms. The next chapter is fever, which includes conditions of circulation and blood like anemia, congestion, pulse, abnormal, full, hard, imperceptible, soft, tremulous, etc. Then the cold stage of fever, that is chilliness in general or in particular parts, both are given. Then coldness of parts, then heat, then the perspiration, then the compound fever, which contains all the three stages, then the concomitants of the fever. So these are subsections of the fever chapter. After the fever chapter or fever section, you get the section of modalities, that is conditions of aggravation and amelioration. Aggravations are much more reported by patients than amelioration and are more noticeable, so they are paid more importance. Then relationship of remedies. The next chapter, or the last chapter, is relationship of remedies. He also added this section, the concordances, which listed extensive and clinically verified remedy relationship. See, he has given clinically verified remedy relationship in this chapter. So the plan and construction of Bhunigasana repertory, we have already discussed that 7 sections are there. Medicines are evaluated in 5 grades. We have already discussed. Now the adaptability of the repertory. It is required in cases having complete symptoms. For the cases with prominent sensation and modalities of one part but vague in the other, so that we can complete them by using doctrine of analogy. So paucity of symptom is also an indication of it. Then the limitation of this repertory. So originally there were only 126 medicine. Dr. Allen dropped 4, added 220, it became 342. So somewhere the originality is lost. Number of rubrics, it lacks in rubrics, which make it difficult for many symptoms to observe. Then the rubrics and medicine. In some rubrics, well-known medicine are omitted. For example, craving for salt, natremur is not there. In some medicines are given undue importance. For example, veritum health is found in every rubric of mind in first grade. So it has been given undue importance. Then the mind section. Bhunigasana has given this chapter only for cross-reference of medicine for proper selection. In mind section, only 17 rubrics are found under intellect section. So mind section is having only in total 18 rubrics, out of which 17 are there in intellect section. So this is a shortcoming of this repertory. Then philosophy of this book stresses on complete symptom, location, sensation, modality, concomitant. But where is the chapter for concomitants in this book? Concomitants are scattered. So this is also a shortcoming. So this is all in this lecture, BTPB part 2. For the end of this lecture, I would like to give you an assignment which contains a question of subjective type, and the question is, what specialty does various sections of Bonnichsen therapeutic pocketbook contain? What specialty does various sections of Bonnichsen therapeutic pocketbook contain? जो आपके 7 सेक्शंस हैं थेरेपेटिक पॉकेट बुक के, उन सबकी क्या स्पेशलिटी है, क्या कैरेक्टरिस्टिक फीचर है, दिस यू हैव टू टेल. सो थैंक्स अ लॉट फॉर बीइंग अटेंटिव. सी यू इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर, दैट इज बीटीबीबी पार्ट 3. Take care of your health. Until then, goodbye.